Ladies and gentlemen, the following is another fantastic episode of the Wrestling Fans Podcast, Ringside Society. I'm your host, that ocean crossing, straight up Boston, flight catching, shot glass snatching, where's he going next? Nobody knows. Three continents down, three more to go. No cap, straight facts, the worldwide star boy, Remy Blue. But it's not about me. You know, you see, we have a special guest tonight. This man is a very talented man with the camera. If you ever want to look good from any angle, he can definitely make it happen. He's actually given us many great shots in the Texas Indies, whether it's reality or wrestling, DFW, he's there making magic. Everybody, welcome to the show, Bryan Hernandez. How you doing tonight, sir?
Pretty good. How are you doing?
Pretty good myself, man. The sun is still out here. I have to start. I didn't know what to say, today or tonight. You know, it's like 7 o'clock here, but the sun is still out, so I kind of got confused there. But other than that, I'm good.
Good, man. Yeah, it's starting to get kind of sundown over here too. So
yeah, it's summertime, man. It is what it is.
Yeah.
So how's everything over there in Texas?
Hot. Very, very hot. You wake up at like 6-7, it's already like 80 degrees, so it gets pretty bad out here.
I couldn't imagine, man. Yeah, I had a friend of mine, she told me she's in Phoenix, Arizona, and one time it was like she was on Snapchat, and I'm like, wait a minute. And she showed the degrees. She had a snap that showed like the temperature at the time, and I'm like, 92 degrees? Wow. She's like, no, that's cool. One time we were like 120, 125. I'm like, sheesh.
Yeah, then you add some humidity to it, and it just gets worse from there, man.
Like, here in New York, you give us anything over like 80, and it's a wrap. Like, we're like, no, we can't take this.
80 is perfect weather around here.
Wow. Yeah, man. So I just gotta say, you know, thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to do this for us. Really appreciate it. We were like, man, you know, we haven't had a photographer on here in a while. The last photographer I think we had was a photographer out of the PNW, Sooner Price, talented young woman, and we had her out of she was actually out of Seattle. And I tell you, y'all photographers, man, y'all got some great talent, man. I tried doing photography one time. And I do it on my end, but it was a Dark Arts Entertainment show. It was like WrestleMania week. It was in California. And I was like, I just couldn't get the right shot. And I was like, nah, this is not good. This is not good. I think I'll just put the camera down. I'm done.
No, it's definitely a trial and error type thing, especially in the independent kind of scene. One day you're in a studio production kind of area, and the next day you're in a warehouse that's got holes and sun coming from one side and not the other. So it's completely different. But no, yeah, it could be a beast of its own sometimes.
Yeah, trust me, y'all definitely know how to make those angles work, man. I tip my hat off to y'all. But tell us, man, you know, how did it all start? How did you become a fan of pro wrestling?
Man, so pro wrestling, you know, it's always been around. Watched it here and there, little kid. My dad started taking me shows. But it actually came like full circle, like every week watching Raw, SmackDown, stuff like that. Man, I was probably like 8 or 9. He took me to a Monday Night Raw taping. Right. And completely changed my life. It was right there, right at the end of the Attitude Era, we're going towards the Ruthless Aggression Era.
Okay.
Eric Bischoff, Ric Flair, Evolution, Triple H. And my dad told me, he went to a show with my mom, and we almost got in a fight with Triple H and Ric Flair. We were second row, and he pulled back on me. I was like, I want to experience that. So he took me to a Raw taping here in Houston, and that was it after that.
Wow, that's awesome. You have like the coolest parents ever, man. Like, that's crazy. Like,
yeah, I've been blessed. I've been to WrestleMania 25. I was there in Dallas a few years back. Night of Champions, that night that Sting got hurt here at Toyota Center. Elimination Chamber, all kinds of house events, live tapings, all kinds of different stuff. So very blessed with my family and helping me out and getting me into this crazy scene we have.
Yeah, WrestleMania 25, the only thing I can remember, that's like one of that. It was okay in a sense, and I know it was in Texas. No, and it wasn't Texas. No, don't get me wrong. You guys have a very rich wrestling history.
Yeah.
But to me, that was like one of the worst WrestleManias I'd ever seen, because I'm like, two things, because and it just didn't resonate with the only thing I can remember from there was the Undertaker Shawn Michaels match.
Everyone says that,
which was good, and I'll never forget Shawn Michaels being, I guess, the light to Undertaker's dark, and he came down ascending from the heavens on the chair and whatnot.
Man, that entrance. What we saw,
yeah,
sitting there watching the thing go up, and you're like, what the hell's going on here? And then all of a sudden you see the big entrance, the light, the spotlight, and it's like, wow, okay, so they're really gonna play on this real hard. Okay, so that was a really cool entrance to see live.
Yeah, that was a pretty good. That was the one match I remember. The other match was the brother versus brother match, Hardy versus Hardy, Jeff versus Matt, and that was it. And oh, of course, the dreaded Miss WrestleMania match
with Tina, right?
Did not care for that match.
I don't think anybody.
The only thing wrong with that match was Santina. I'm sorry. I'm probably gonna get canceled or whatnot, but I did not care for Santina Marella. She could have done anything else, but the fact that if she had gotten thrown out, fine, I would have been cool with it. But the fact that they actually had her win, I'm like, are you serious? We get to see divas of the past and the present and maybe even the future, and you have Santina Marella making a mockery of it. Like, yeah, that WrestleMania was something else.
You know, going into the creative part, you're like, okay, so what were you thinking there? But, you know, it's in the past, and they definitely had a moment there, so.
Yeah, yeah. They definitely did. So, you're going to the shows and everything, and you're cheering your favorites, and, you know, you're supporting and whatnot. How did you end up going to the indies now?
Man, so I was never opened up to the indies until I actually started doing this. You know, I'd always seen GCW, I've seen posts, stuff like that. I've seen smaller indie stuff just being posted, like just little clips and highlights, reels, you know, social media stuff. And then it came to the point in my photography kind of journey where I'm like, you know, I love what I do. I've been a photographer for about 10 years now. Portrait stuff, headshot stuff like that. And I'm like, man, I really love it. But what really got me into photography was sports. And a huge baseball fan, huge football fan. And I was like, why won't I just incorporate this with something, the two things that I love, wrestling and my photography. And I messaged one of our local indies. I was like, hey, you know, I'm literally a no name, but I'm a photographer. Here's some work that I've done for different sports. Do you mind just giving me a chance? Don't got to pay me. Just want an experience. Just want to see if I can even do it. And they're absolutely. So from there, it started there at PWF here in Houston. And then my name got thrown around a little bit, ROW. Russell Rave, just other companies that were here in the Houston area, talent putting out my name out there, and that's where it kind of got introduced to the indie scene. And you know, it's crazy because it's a whole different world. Everyone loves WWE, everyone loved Impact, you know, everyone loves AEW, and that's a great product to watch because it's televised, it's something that you resonate. But the heart, as soon as I went to that first PWF show and hearing the heart of the crowd, completely different environment. You know, you're thousands and thousands of people in an arena, but when you go to an indie show, it's 100 people and they can be just as loud as those thousands in a huge arena. So that's what really got me into the indie stuff.
Oh yeah, the indie, to me, you're definitely right about the indie show and whatnot. Like, it could be just as loud as, you know, a show at the big companies. Although in my opinion, from my experience, you know, going there not just as a fan but as a podcaster, it's a bit of a different environment as well too. Whereas, you know, you go to the big company shows. Yeah, you know, everybody, you have, you know, the hardcore wrestling fans. But then you have the ones that are casual and everything. Whereas when you go to the indie shows, it seems like it's a bit of like a family type vibe. Like, everybody knows everybody. Yeah. And that's the vibe that I've always enjoyed.
And then it's also just like a one-on-one thing. Because you go to a WWE show, you go to an AEW show. After the show, there's no intermission, you know, unless you're going to a house show. But even during their intermissions, you're going to get some from concession stand. You're going to get merch from some guy that they just hired down the street. But when you go to an indie show, you're buying an 8x10. You're buying a shirt from that physical wrestler. You take 5 minutes to talk to him, take a handshake, take a picture. And, you know, it's a one-on-one experience, and it's completely different. Yeah.
I like it because of the networking, because I can get to talk to like wrestlers and referees and whatnot and be like, hey, I run this podcast. You know, I mean, some of them are like, but I just started. I'm like, I don't care if you just started out, man. Like, we could talk about that one match. We're that good. Or you just ref one match. Let's talk about that one match you ref. Let's talk about the feeling and everything you got. You know, you meet like you meet like-minded fans. And I've met several fans that have like, that have actually like been in the same wrestling media community as I am, and I've collaborated with them. I had one woman actually asked me to collaborate in when I was in LA. So it's stuff like that that's really cool. About that makes indie shows really cool and everything.
Exactly. You never know who you're gonna meet, because everybody's there for the one show, and then all of a sudden you're collaborating, just off.
Yeah.
Hey man, you want some water or something? And instantly you've created basically like a family.
Like, I will never forget. I was at the same Dark Art show, and I saw Cal Jack, who used to be with WWE, and I started making a chant, "Let's go, Cal Jack!" And he actually looked over and he saw me. So the crowd started chanting it too after me. And then all of a sudden, he was like, he saw what I was doing. He's like, yeah. And so like after the match now, after the show and everything, I'm standing in line to go to the next show, which is in the same building. It was one of those like type setups where you had several different promotions running one after the other. And so I'm like, okay, awesome. I'm in line for the next show. I see Kyle Jack. He walks up to me. He gives me a fist bump. And he's like, "Hey, bro, thank you for starting that chant." I was like, "Wow!" Like, I never had that happen before.
Yeah, it's a completely different experience, and especially like with the indie stuff, because you're so close to this talent that's there in the indie shows. One conversation can become a huge friendship and backing each other up and all kinds of different stuff. So it's a great experience.
Yeah. So tell us, man. So you say your dad, you know, took you to your first wrestling show. What was his reaction? What was your parents' reaction when you told them, "Hey, I'm now a photographer for several wrestling promotions here in Texas"?
So it's really funny, because again, my parents have really been interested in wrestling, and you know, it's always been, you do what you want to do, you make your own story, but we're going to pave the path for you to do it the correct way. So just going back a little bit, you know, as a normal teenager, hey, I want to make some money. Okay, perfect. What do you want to do in your life? Like, I really want to be a photographer. Perfect. Then you're not going to go work at McDonald's. Because what is flipping a burger going to do for you learning how to take pictures? So it started off there. So, you know, working where I'm at now, great. You know, you're doing what you're doing. This is a stepping stone. Now you keep going where you want to end up. And as soon as I told him, you know, I'm going to be photographing wrestling, it's like, wow. You know, you remember those hard talks we used to have. You're not going to go to a Chick-fil-A. You're not going to go to a McDonald's to do what you're doing. That's why I did what I did. And it's been nothing but positivity. Once I told my mom, you know, I'm actually getting a chance to go shoot with Booker T. And she's like, make sure you tell him that I'm his woman on the side, but I'm his woman. I'm like, Mom, I can't do that. This is the first.
Wow.
Come on now. So it's always been like that. Huge wrestling fans around our house. So, you know,
I can imagine support. I can imagine Charmel going, tell me she did not just say
that. I still have not told Booker this.
I want to talk to you.
I'm not going to say nothing. All right. But no, yeah, definitely big, huge support from my family. And, you know, they like, hey, how'd it go? Every night that I come home from a show, how'd it go? How was it? Was it fun? Remember, always have fun. If you're not having fun, it's not worth it anymore. So I've always had that backing behind them.
Well, you know, I'm glad you actually jumped the guardrail the right way and joined the pro wrestling. I know that's a new expression I started. Now, I don't know if it's going to catch on, but that's just, I couldn't find any other expression to use as to when a fan decides to get involved in the wrestling industry. So I said, hey, you jumped the guardrail the right way. But, you know, congrats on doing that. You know, I hope it leads to many, many bigger things. Like when I told my co-host Kathy Knight, I'm sure you've seen her around the shows, but she's like, yeah, I know him. He took a picture of me when I was kneeling to Rachel Rose. And I'm like, oh, okay. Well, she just knows everybody. So
it's not surprising. Familiar face, a very familiar face.
Yeah. It's not surprising that she does that. Cause she's a huge fan of the Texas wrestling scene. She's gone to Reality Wrestling, New Texas Pro, several others. So yeah, she's she knows a lot of people there too, and people know her as well. So it's not surprising when I mention somebody, she's like, oh yeah, I know that person there, so and so and so, and we've talked, and they did this, and so. But yeah, so with the photography thing now, man. So tell us, man, what was a time where you thought you had a bad day with the photography at the show? And then they told you, nah, bro, you were good. Like, this is like magazine worthy. And you were like, really? Like, unbelievable. Like, pretty much like left in disbelief.
Man, to be completely honest, I'm the worst person to ask that question because it's every day. Every day. And it's definitely an internal thing because I my biggest thing is I love seeing the reaction of the fans. I love seeing the reaction of the talent. You're like, wow, thank you so much for that. Love it. Love it when they post them as a profile picture or, hey, can you send me a few more? Love it. But it's just a thing. I'm sitting there as soon as I'm done with the show, uploading pictures and I have a whole little process of like, these are the pictures I want to use. So I'm looking. I'm like, Jesus. And then writing down numbers. I'm like, man, I don't think I have enough. And then I look down at my page. I have like 50 pictures in. I'm like, oh, okay, well, let's see what the turnout is on these. And then that's when I feel that satisfaction of like, no, these are really good. It's always something that I have a problem with, but seeing the feedback from it is always so, I guess just makes it seem real at that point. That it is worthy for posting, you know?
Yeah, I'm like that too sometimes. Like when I take my pictures and whatnot, like when I do my little photo shoots, I always ask a client, I'm like, how are these photos? Are they good? You know, are they? Because I always have that doubt, like, I don't want to fail. Although failing is, you only fail if you don't learn from it and do the same thing. Yeah. You only fail if you fall and don't get back up. If you fail, but you're still at it, you're still willing to learn, it's gonna get better. That's what I gotta keep telling myself. And I've had times when I've had those doubts. I'm like, I don't know if this looks good. I don't know if I want to send this to them. And then I ask them, how is it? They're like, yeah, it looks good. I'm like, are you sure? I mean, they could do it again. I mean, they're like,
yeah,
no, it's good as the way it is. So I'm like, I guess if they say so, you know, it is, it's actually pretty good.
Yeah. And that's the biggest thing that I've always asked for is honest feedback, because the whole point of this and me doing wrestling photography, there's an end game, you know, with everything, there's an end game. You want, just like as talent, you want to make it to the big show. Even on the production side, you want to make it to the big show. I will never get there if I keep doing the same thing, because I'm getting the same answers. I want honest criticism. I want honest feedback. And that's the only way to progress in what you're doing, is to get that. So I definitely get where you're coming from there.
Yeah. But honestly, I got to say, you know, the work that y'all are doing is definitely, I always say, if I ever get down to Texas, man, y'all could take as many pictures of me in the stands as much as I want. I would not be mad, man. It would be an honor. Like, there's one guy, and I swear, I would definitely, like, I know you probably heard of him, Greg Tagg. He does the most amazing portraits. I'm like, bro, if I ever got a picture by you, I would definitely, like, yo, Greg Tagg just took my picture. Like, yo, I'd be over above the moon right now.
Yeah, no, there's a bunch of talent here. There's all kinds of different talent, just in general, just some of the stuff that pops up on my feed. You know, I love following the other photographers. You've got to get to know everybody, because again, we're all working together. So
yeah,
the amount of talent that's around here is crazy.
And what I must say, you know, I got to tip my hat off to you again, because you not only have your photography, but you branded it, and you actually have your merch, and you're wearing it right now. So I gotta say, that just goes to show how serious you are about your brand, is that you're actually wearing your shirt. So
it's real.
You're definitely gonna go far, man.
Thank you.
So I just got a few more questions. So 5 years from now, where does Bryan Hernandez, where does he see himself in BLH photography 5 years from now?
Man, so 5 years from now, you know, continue what I'm doing for sure, is number one. Making a little bit more of a difference in my community with this. You know, I sell my 8x10s, I sell to the wrestlers, I sell to fans. But you know, sponsoring talent, here in a bit, that I think PWF was picking up non-perishables for local community. So being able to use the money that I earn from my business, from my photography business alone, I want to be able to make a difference. That's for sure one thing. To a little bit more publications, you know, I've been real lucky. One of the wrestlers used my photo in a book that she was publicized in, and I had the author come out and reach out to me. Hey, do you mind me using this image? You know, I heard that you're the photographer, love the photo credit. So I was like, no, yeah, absolutely. You go ahead. So more magazines, books, stuff like that. Maybe even hopefully I've tried to test the waters a little bit, but PWI, you know, the wrestling magazine, Pro Wrestling Illustrated, freelancing even for them would be great. Definitely dreams that are reachable for sure in the next 5 years. But again, like I said, the end game is making it to the big leagues, you know?
Right. Yeah. And honestly, I just gotta say, just keep on doing what you're doing. I wish you nothing but the best with getting to the big leagues. Just don't forget us little people down here. No. You know, best be if I see, oh, Bryan Hernandez is elite, is all elite, or Bryan Hernandez signs with WB as their photographer or Impact, I'll be like, awesome, he did it, man. We had that guy on the show. Now he's a big time photographer, man. Like Speedy, who does the AEW photography. I'd be like, yeah, man, he made it.
Yeah.
You know.
Definitely reaching out to them. You know, it's I've actually asked them, and great people to actually, you know, in this area, like in this kind of craziness of photography, there is some competition, you know, and some people don't want their spot to be taken, whatever. But Speedy's been a guy that was, I messaged, I was like, hey, you know, I just started doing this. I want to just get some feedback, see if I'm taking the right route. How did you get to where you're at? And great information back from him. And he left that avenue open to ask any questions. So I'm real grateful for stuff like that. And just the people that are like that. He said, don't forget nobody. You can't, you know, I was always brought up that way. Don't step on the people that while you go up, because you're going to meet them again, coming right back down when it happens. So you can't, right. You can't. And again, this indie scene, it's a family. It really is. Whether it be the talent, the producers, the promoter, the camera people at the arena, you really get to know them, and it's a family. You can't step on that.
Oh yeah, definitely, man. That's why I always said, man, you know, it's funny because I thought back to myself. I always said when I started this podcast, I wanted to give everybody a shot. I wanted to have a platform where everybody could tell their story, and the wrestling fans, my fellow wrestling fans and myself, can get to hear those stories, not just from the pro wrestlers perspective, but from the referees, the promoters, and of course, you know, y'all, the photographers as well too. And you know, I've heard several great stories, and I gotta say, man, like it's I'm glad that we actually started doing this, because only we would have been missing out on a lot. And I'm you know my favorite photo for you that you've done here is the one with Rudy Garza. That one.
Which one? From ROW?
The one where he looks like Seth Rollins and he has his like shirt open. Yeah. His tongue was out. I was like, yo, this is clutch, man.
I'm blessed in the area that I'm photographing in, because there's so many talent, and not just necessarily like in ring, but the charisma that people have. Rudy is, he is so easy to photograph, because he's gonna give you some raw emotions, and it's either gonna be real funny, it's gonna be real serious, or you're really gonna hate the guy. And all that is him doing his job right. So I'm blessed with the talent that's around here, because they make my job so much easier.
Yeah, and then you have another favorite of mine that you did was the aftermath of Gigi Ray and Promise Braxton, where she has the title and she has her head. And I was that gave me Shawn Michaels WrestleMania 13, or no, Shawn Michaels WrestleMania 12 vibes, when he finally won the world title, and they're like, the boyhood dream has come true. Yeah. That reminded me so much of that scene as well. So
again, two easy talent to photograph, and they're always so cool. You know, it's really cool knowing and being able to talk to some of the people, because they're like, before the show, they're like, hey, where are you gonna be at, and make sure I'm looking for you. Like, I'm right here. And it again, the talent make it so easy, because they give that aura, and when they get into it, they get into it, and it's so easy to be like, perfect, I've got the perfect angle, or perfect, hey, just give me one quick second, and bam, it's right there.
Wow, that's awesome, man. Yeah, y'all definitely keep the good work. I'll tell you what, y'all say there's competition, but I can tell you right now, when it comes to being on Ringside Society, there's no competition, man. It's just a DM away, and we can make it happen. So we appreciate all y'all, man, regardless. But with that being said, I just got one more question before we shut the show down. My last question is, if somebody came up to you and says, you know, hey, Bryan, I want to get into, you know, wrestling photography, I want to get into ringside photography and everything, what advice would you give that person?
You know, I listen to a lot of podcasts, and it's, you know, easy stuff, and it's all the old guys talking about paying your dues, and it's the same thing on the production side, especially doing the indie thing. You've got to pay your due. Put your name out there. Just take a chance on yourself, and then you do it, and you do it, and you do it, and you do it over and over and over again, whether you're getting paid for it, whether you're doing it for free, pay your dues and get your miles in, because that's the only way you're going to succeed in this. You do one, sure, that's great, you did one, but if you don't do something the next week or the next month, then you'll never get back out there. You know what I mean? So stay at it and pay your dues, whether you feel like you're not getting anywhere, you keep doing it for free. You got to do something to start. So pay your dues by doing it. That's my biggest, advice on doing this.
Awesome. So for those of you that are looking to get into, you know, the wrestling photography or just sports photography in general, you just got some advice from one of the people that are doing it and doing it pretty well, taking photographs in reality of wrestling, DFW, pretty much a lot of the indies that you know in Texas. This man is actually making it happen. So you just got a bit of advice from him. Anything else, you probably got to, you know, hit him up, you know, maybe hit up a PayPal or Cash App or whatever. He'll probably help you out in that way. You know, once you do that,
don't be afraid to ask questions, whether it's anybody, anyone around ringside. You see them. We all have Instagrams. We all have Facebooks. Shoot us a DM. More than likely, we're going to help. You know, I'm definitely one of those people, because again, you don't step on anyone going up because you're going to meet them going back down. So I'm willing to help anyone and ask any questions, answer any questions, shoot, just go out and shoot. I'm definitely into it. So definitely ask questions.
Awesome. Well, I gotta say, Bryan, it was a pleasure having you on the show. You know, on behalf of myself, Kathy Knight and Rob Bass, we thank you for, you know, taking time to talk wrestling with us. We really and truly appreciate it. We actually wish you nothing but the best with your, you know, sports photography career and everything. And look forward to seeing your, you know, work in publications worldwide and everything. Before we actually, you know, shut the show down, where can fans find you on social media when they want to check out your work? And also, where can, you know, bookers and promoters find you when they want to book you for their shows? And also, where can wrestlers find you when they want to get that crisp 8x10 that they can actually sell themselves, or they can actually use when they apply to the big time promotions all over the world?
Yeah, no. So my Instagram, I've got BLH Photography. BLH.photography with two underscores at the end. That's my Instagram. Right now, it's a very high-paced posting. Right now, I'm on WrestleRave from last month. I just finished up ROW. We're coming up on Summer of Champions this weekend, so right after that, I've got PWF to post the week coming up, and then ROW right after. So definitely, there's a lot of stuff there. And then my Facebook's going to be Bryan Hernandez, parenthesis BLH Photography. And you can always reach out on me. I always answer my DMs there, personal messages, anything like that, whether it be talent, fans. I sell 8x10s to the fans. I've got signed stuff. I've got just normal 8x10s. I sell to the talent too. I can shoot promos for you guys, anything like that. And we send over a quick PNG. Whatever you need, we can definitely get that worked out for you. So definitely just shoot me a message if you need a ringside photographer, you need some promos, you're looking to buy some 8x10s, anything like that, definitely reach out on my social medias.
So y'all definitely, so pretty much what he's saying, whether you're a fan looking to buy 8x10s or a promoter ringside photographer or a wrestler looking to get those promo shots done, hit up this man. He just gave his social media links. Trust me, it'll definitely be worth it. But with that being said, it's about time for us to shut this show down. Y'all don't go too far, because we have another guest after this one. As a matter of fact, coming up in roughly an hour and, I guess, 15 minutes, we'll be having the Rocket, Josiah Jean, on our show. A man who has actually been making a name for himself in reality of wrestling and DFW All Pro. He'll be on here in an hour and some change. But if you want to find me on social media, not that I say a lot of cool stuff, but I do go to a lot of cool places every now and then, y'all can definitely find me on Twitter and Instagram at TheRemyBlue. You can also find me on Facebook under the name Remy Blue, obviously. And our podcast is also on social media. We're on Twitter and Instagram at Ringside Society, Twitch at Ringside Society 2019. We're on Facebook as a Facebook group. We're also on Spotify. I know we're also on Threads now. I guess Threads is a thing now. Instagram started it. I guess they're like, hey, we're going to dip into the world of Twitter. So we're on Threads. It's the same thing at Ringside Society. Follow us on there. And we also have a Teespring store where we sell official Ringside Society merchandise. We have t-shirts, we have tank tops, we have hoodies, long sleeve shirts. We even have coffee mugs for your favorite beverages as well too. And we just dropped our luxury edition t-shirt. That's our seventh design, and it's actually also our first design ever to be inspired by a pro wrestler, none other than our alumni guest, the Diamond Sheik. We just dropped that, so definitely check it out. And we're dropping our Miami Life edition t-shirt very soon. Be on the lookout for that. But check us out. Cop some merchandise. All proceeds go back into keeping our show afloat. They do not go back into our pockets. And last but not least, we have a YouTube channel where we have cool interviews like this one, like the one we have with Greg Tag, like the one we also have with Sooner Price, and many other great photographers and wrestlers, promoters, men and women in the professional wrestling industry. All you got to do is go on YouTube, type in Ringside Society. Once you see that really handsome dark blue and light blue yin-yang sound with the blue flames around it, that's to my right, or whichever, however you're seeing it, that's when you know it's us. So make sure you subscribe to all our videos, because we got a lot of cool stuff coming up. You don't want to miss a thing, like Aerosmith in 1998. But with that being said, we just want to let everybody know that we just want to thank everybody that tuned in live tonight. We really and truly appreciate it. We're not done yet. So those of y'all that are listening later on, we get a chance, thank you very much in advance. And those of y'all that hate us, can't stand us, really and truly wish we'd go away. Well, like myself at Gordon Corral, we're not going anywhere for a while. And, you know, we just want to let everybody know, you know, myself, Kathleen, and Rob Bates, we're very well aware of everybody and their grandparents and the parents of a podcast. But we're not your grandparents' podcast. We're not your parents' podcast. As a matter of fact, we're not just any podcast. Hashtag, we are not the same. So with that being said, I'm going to say it one time for the mind, one time for the people, one time for the wrestling culture, one time for the Texas indie scene, and one time for the magnificent work of Bryan Hernandez, BLH Photography, with the Wrestling Fans Podcast, Ringside Society. We'll be back in an hour and change with another impressive guest on another impressive episode. But until then, we just want y'all to do four favors for us. Stay safe, stay healthy, be excellent to each other, and party on, dudes. We out. Peace.
Thank you.